Lloyd Woolner from Lowestoft in Suffolk, Susanna Fleet from Cambridge, Malcolm Forbes from Walesby in Nottinghamshire, Stephen Reynolds from Kenarth in Carmarthenshire, Pip Fish from Abridge in Hampshire, Geoffrey Donaldson from Orpington in Kent, Amy Godel from Wolvercote in Oxfordshire, Brian McGuinness from Pontefract in West Yorkshire, Kate Ogilvie from Huddersfield, Darren Purcell from Port Sumner in County Galway, Beatrice Baldwin from Slinfold in West Sussex, Mike Jarvis from Longditton in Surrey, Robert Potter from Dorchester, Matt Owen from Spalding in Lincolnshire, and Andy Oates from Torquay are all here to play 15 to 1. Introduced by William G. Stewart.
Thank you. Hello. Our previous winner today is Amy Godel from Wolvercote in Oxfordshire, who's been a winner twice before and who was with us in the grand final a couple of weeks ago. Welcome back, Amy. We've got a couple of decent scores on the finals board for today's lineup to aim at. There it is. It's early days, but those are the kind of scores that will be needed for any chance of a place in the grand final. But as usual, things start to get interesting with our first winning score above 200. Let's see if someone with us today has it in them. Two questions each in the first round, one correct answer from you to survive, and we begin with Lloyd Woolner from Lowestoft in Suffolk. Lloyd, on which date of each year does the new car registration year begin in the United Kingdom?
August the 1st.
Susanna, please. The name, please, of the organisation which staged the protest on March the 1st when over 250,000 people demonstrated in London. The Countryside Alliance. Malcolm, please. Television. Which daytime television presenter on BBC One worked as a lecturer at Liverpool University and was a Member of Parliament before entering television?
Austin Mitchell.
Robert Kilroy Silk. Stephen, please. Theatre. The name, please, of the new musical by Andrew Lloyd Webber and Jim Steinman, which opens in London in July, based on a 1962 film starring Hayley Mills. Whistle Down the Wind. Pip, BBC Radio 4. Sunday at 12:15, repeated at 9:05 a.m. on the following Friday. Which programme?
Any questions?
Desert Island Discs. Geoffrey? Sport and the USA. Which famous annual sporting event that is televised worldwide took place at the Qualcomm Stadium in San Diego on the 25th of January?
The Super Bowl.
Amy, please. 19th century English literature. Silas Marner, The Mill on the Floss, Adam Bede. The author, please.
George Eliot.
Brian, The Bible, St John, chapter 1. Before he became a disciple of Jesus, Andrew had been a follower of whom?
John the Baptist.
Yes, Brian. Kate, which famous Norwegian, born in 1914, led two memorable voyages, one on a balsa wood raft called Kontiki, the other on a papyrus boat named Ra 2?
Tor Heyerdahl.
Darren, please. Classical music. The Flying Dutchman, Tannhäuser, Lohengrin. The composer, please.
Edward Grieg.
Wagner. Richard Wagner. Beatrice, of which West Indian island is Bridgetown the capital?
Barbados.
Mike, please. Degrees. The letters LLB after a person's name indicate a degree in what?
Literature.
Law. Robert, please. The Romans named the Atlantic Ocean. What did they name it after?
God of the Sea.
The Atlas Mountains in North Africa. Matt, the legal system. After the Lord Chief Justice, the holder of which title is the most senior judge in England and Wales?
Master of the Scrolls.
Master
of the Rolls.
Yes. Sorry. Andy, please. Monarchy. Who is the present Queen of the Netherlands?
Beatrice.
Well, Beatrix, yes. And Lloyd, your second question. Charles Dickens. Which Dickens novel is partly set in the Marshalsea prison for debtors and revolves around the fluctuating fortunes of two families?
I have to go for Bleak House.
Little Dorrit. Susanna, musical instruments. What name is given to the gourd rattles of South American dance music?
Maracas.
Malcolm, please. Literature, Lorna Doone, A Romance of Exmoor. Who wrote it?
R.D. Blackmore.
Stephen, please. The NHS Patients' Charter. According to the Patients' Charter, the standard laid down is 14 minutes for urban areas and 19 minutes in rural areas. For what?
No idea.
Ambulances arriving at emergencies. Pip, please, the game of chess. For what title do the initials IGM stand?
International Grandmaster?
Yes. And Geoffrey, literary connections. Which poet connects the Cotswold village of Burnt Norton, East Coker in Somerset and Little Gidding in Cambridgeshire?
Laurie Lee.
T.S. Eliot. Amy, the House of Commons. On which day of the week does the 30-minute-long Prime Minister's Questions now take place?
Wednesdays.
Brian, please. By what name are the upper reaches of the River Thames known at Oxford?
Isis.
Kate, please. Quotations. Which British film star famously described his own acting technique as left eyebrow raised, right eyebrow raised?
Cary Grant.
That could only be Dear Roger Moore, that one. And Darren, the United States, the cities of Davenport, Cedar Rapids and Des Moines are in which state?
Philadelphia.
Iowa. Beatrice, business and commerce. In March, W.H. Smith announced it's to buy which rival high street retail chain for £68 million?
Watersons.
John Menzies. And Mike, please. What position on the American political stage is held by the Republican Congressman Newt Gingrich?
Speaker of the House of Representatives.
He is indeed. Robert, newspapers, the cartoon strips, Fred Bassett, Peanuts and Bogart. In which national daily newspaper do they all appear?
Daily Express.
The Daily Mail. Matt, please, the Bible. The name, please, of Abraham's son, born to him in old age, whom he was prepared to sacrifice to prove his trust in God.
Isaac.
Andy, please. Proverbs. He travels fastest who travels...
lightest.
Alone. Three down, 12 to go. Philip, please.
And they are Stephen Reynolds, Darren Purcell and Robert Potter. And of the remaining 12 contestants, three still have their three lives intact.
We finished round one with Proverbs, Lloyd. We start round two with Proverbs. Procrastination is the thief of... what?
Of the devil.
Time. Susanna, the calendar. AD is the abbreviation for Anno Domini. AM is the abbreviation for Anno Mundi. What does Anno Mundi mean?
Before noon.
In the year of the world. And Malcolm, please, what in India are the Lok Sabha and Raja Sabha?
Desert.
The lower and upper houses of Parliament. Pip, please, what does the adjective sororal or sororial mean?
Sisterly.
Yes, exactly. A number, please, Pip.
11.
Beatrice, in some Jewish communities, there is a ceremony for girls which is equivalent to the bar mitzvah ceremony for boys. What's it called?
No.
A bat mitzvah or bath mitzvah. Again, please, Pip.
14.
Quotations, Matt. Four legs good, two legs bad. From which George Orwell novel does that come?
Animal Farm.
A number, please.
Number three, please.
Theatrical awards, Malcolm. At the 1998 Laurence Olivier Awards in February, Ian Holm was named Best Actor and Sir Richard Eyre Best Director. For which Shakespeare play?
Henry the...
King Lear. Again, please, Matt.
Number seven, please.
Amy, honours and awards in the United Kingdom. Honours lists can appear two or three times in a year, but which list always appears in June?
The Queen's birthday.
A number, please.
Number 15, please.
And Andy, 20th century music. Which 20th century American composer created a piece called 4 minutes and 33 seconds, which is in fact 4.5 minutes of silence?
Sorry, no idea.
John Cage. Again, please, Amy.
Number 6, please.
Shakespeare, Geoffrey, Romeo and Juliet. Which character in the play acts as a go-between during the early romance of Romeo and Juliet?
The nurse.
A number, please, Geoffrey.
Number 12.
A sinophile is someone who likes and is attracted to which race or culture, Mike?
Japanese.
Chinese. Again, please, Geoffrey.
Number 11.
Furniture, Beatrice. What are the distinguishing features of a Pembroke table?
Does it open out so it can be made larger?
It can, but you have to tell me how, because there are various methods of doing that.
It breaks in the middle.
No, it has two hinged flaps. It's a drop leaf table. Again, please, another number?
Number 9.
The royal family. What family relationship is there between the holders of the titles Baron Greenwich and Baron Killyleagh?
Brothers?
Father and son. It's Prince Philip and the Duke of York. Again, Geoffrey, please.
Number 2.
And Susanna, theatre again. How is the name of the American actress Antoinette Perry remembered in the American theatre world?
I don't know.
The major annual theatre awards are named after her. They're the Tonys. Again, please.
Number 1.
And Lloyd, the Bible, the New Testament. Who in Revelations symbolise conquest, slaughter, famine and death, the horrors of war?
The four horsemen of apocalypse.
Yes, the number, please, Lloyd.
14, sorry.
Media, Matt. What similar jobs in the media are held by Peter Stothard, Alan Rusbridger and Charles Moore?
They're editors.
Yes, they are, of The Times, The Guardian and The Daily Telegraph.
5, please.
Science, please, and chemistry, Pip. The two lightest known chemical elements are the main constituents of the sun. Which two elements?
Oxygen and hydrogen.
Hydrogen and helium. Again, please, Matt.
Number 6, please.
Famous couples, Geoffrey. The war reporter Martha Gellhorn, who died recently at the age of 89, was formerly married to which famous American writer?
Ernest Hemingway.
Indeed, Geoffrey.
Number 15.
Andy, the USA. Which of the 50 states lies on the Beaufort Sea?
Florida.
Alaska. Again, please, Geoffrey.
Number 8.
Opera, please, Brian. Which Donizetti opera is set in Windsor in 1536 with roles including Henry VIII, Anne Boleyn, Jane Seymour and Richard Percy?
No idea.
Anna Bolena. Again, please, Geoffrey.
Number 7.
This is theatre, please, Amy. The name, please, given to that part of the stage in front of the proscenium arch, which in some theatres can be extended over the pit.
The apron.
And number, please, Amy.
Number 14.
Matt, the Mosque of Omar in Jerusalem covers the spot from where it is believed Muhammad ascended to heaven. By what other name is that shrine more commonly known? The Dome of the Rock. Again, please, Amy.
Number 1, please.
Business and current affairs. Lloyd, it was recently announced that two supermarket chains have agreed on a £1.45 billion merger. Either of the two supermarkets, please.
Asda.
Quicksave and Summerfield. Again, please, Amy.
Number 8, please.
Capital cities, Brian. Santiago is the capital city of which South American country?
Chile.
A number, please, Brian.
And number 12.
And Mike. The name, please, of the former Prime Minister of Zambia who has been charged with misprision of treason by the government.
Abe Mutareya.
Kenneth Kaunda. Again, please, Brian.
Number 9.
The animal world, Kate. What name is given to the crossbred dog, which is usually a cross between a greyhound and a collie? Lurcher. Brian, please.
14.
The Bible, Matt. Aaron is the brother of Moses. What's the name of their sister?
Ruth.
Miriam. Again, please, Brian.
Number 5.
Pip, musical terms. What word is used to describe the simultaneous union of sounds of a different pitch?
Record.
Yes, Pip. A number, please.
14.
Famous quotations, Matt. This one from Samuel Johnson. When a man is tired of London, what comes next?
He's tired of life.
A number, please, Matt.
Number 8, please.
And this is 20th century writers. Whose novel sees the author's native Dublin through the eyes of two characters, dispossessed wanderers, who each set out on the 16th of June 1904 without a door key?
James Joyce.
Yes, Ulysses.
Number 5.
And Pip, mammals. The order Chiroptera comprises the only mammals that can truly fly. Which mammals?
Birds?
Bats. Again, please, Brian.
14.
Matt, which Commonwealth country, then a British colony, was Elizabeth II visiting when her father died and she became Queen in 1952?
Australia.
Kenya. I thought that was pretty tough, I must say. After the break, Geoffrey Donaldson from Orpington in Kent, Amy Godel from Wolvercote in Oxfordshire and Brian McGuinness from Pontefract in West Yorkshire will be here for the final. Do please stay with us.
stuck in a dead-end job. We have nothing to look forward to. To never be told thank you.
To be a creep.
To be bullied by my boss.
Yes, Mr. Smith.
Thank you, Mr. Smith.
To never be asked my opinion.
To never have an opinion.
To pretend to myself I like my job.
You're just a click away from the job you deserve.
Who could insure your car for less with a choice of monthly payments?
Budget!
Who offers great service with no forms to fill in?
Budget!
And who gives you a 3-year guarantee on repairs?
Budget!
Join the thousands of drivers who are now switching their car insurance to...
Budget!
To find out if you could be better off with Budget, call us now on 0800 247 247. That's 0800 247 247.
Budget!
You'll like our prices, you'll love our service.
Surviving contestants in today's 15-1 final are Geoffrey Donaldson, a retired bank official from Orpington in Kent. He's been retired for 9 years, and he enjoys playing badminton, gardening, and reading, with a special interest in naval history. Amy Godel, a hypnotherapist from Wolvercote in Oxfordshire. Her hobbies are crosswords, cooking, and travel, and she's shortly to visit Costa Rica. An animal lover, she's devoted to her 2 cats. And Brian McGuinness, a barman from Pontefract in West Yorkshire. Originally from Clonis in County Monaghan, he's lived in Yorkshire for 16 years. He's a member of his local quiz leagues, and he also enjoys reading crime fiction and the works of Tom Clancy.
Thank you. Welcome back. Geoffrey, Amy, Brian, you know what's required. Put your fingers on the buzzers. Here we go. Which famous children's story originated one afternoon in July 1862 when the author and his friend Robinson Duckworth took 3 daughters of Dean Liddell on a boating... Amy?
Alice in Wonderland.
Indeed. Olympics and athletics. Which 2-day event for men begins with the 100... Amy?
Decathlon.
It does indeed. What begins with these words? I swear by Apollo the physician... Amy?
The Hippocratic Oath.
It does indeed. You have 3 correct answers. Question or nominate?
Question, please.
The European Union regulations and the church. What food substances have recently been brought within EU use-by-date regulations, causing great consternation among Vatican officials and Roman Catholic priests in Italy?
Communion wafers.
Indeed they have. Question or nominate?
Question, please.
Who, please tell me, is that man there?
Rupert Murdoch.
Question or nominate?
Question, please.
The human body. What common name is given to the occasion when the erector pili muscles in the human body contract and cause the skin to be covered with small lumps?
Goose pimples.
Question or nominate?
Question.
Clockwise round a dartboard. 20 is at the top. Which number is next?
1.
Question or nominate?
I think I'd better nominate Geoffrey, please.
Geoffrey, his father won the Medal of Honor for heroism in the American Civil War, 1861 to 65. He won the same award for his defense of the Philippines in 1941-42. Which famous and controversial US general?
General MacArthur.
Question or nominate?
Nominate Brian.
London, the Ritz Hotel, Fortnum & Mason, and the Royal Academy of Arts stand on which London thoroughfare?
The Strand.
Piccadilly. Geoffrey again, please.
Amy.
Amy, pop music. Which major rock star got his professional name because he used to wear a striped jumper that made him look like a wasp?
Stink.
Question or nominate?
Question, please.
A 2-part answer. To which 2 islands was Napoleon exiled from 1814 to 15 and then from 1815 to 21?
Elba and St. Helena.
Question or nominate?
Question.
Nursery rhymes. Who in a famous nursery rhyme was disturbed whilst eating her food by a large arachnid?
Miss Muffet.
Yes, little Miss Muffet. Question or nominate?
Question.
Musical instruments. What's the Greek name for the pear-shaped metal-strung lute played in Greek cafes and films?
Balalaika.
That's the Russian one. This is bouzouki. Fingers back on the buzzers, please. English law. Which ancient right, if charged with treason or felony, was surrendered by the House of Lords in 1948? Geoffrey?
The right of trial by the Lords.
Well, yeah, to be tried by their peers, yes,
yeah.
OK. Question or nominate?
Nominate Brian.
Brian, the Bible and another 2-part answer, please. The waters of which sea were parted to allow the Israelites to leave Egypt and of which river to allow them to enter the Promised Land?
The Red Sea. And the River Jordan.
Question or nominate?
Nominate Amy.
The royal family, Amy. What's the name of the Queen's private secretary?
Sir Robert Fellows.
Question or nominate?
Geoffrey, please.
Geoffrey, look at that, please, and tell me, who is that famous conductor?
Simon Rattle.
Sir Colin Davis. Amy again, please. Question or nominate?
Brian, please.
Brian, motorways. Which motorway runs between Birmingham and Exeter?
The M5.
Question or nominate?
Geoffrey.
Geoffrey, what word in English meaning someone who takes the blame or is given the blame comes from the Old Testament ritual of Yom Kippur?
Scapegoat.
Yes, Geoffrey. Question or nominate?
Nominate Amy.
Amy, the USA. What part have three men called John Wilkes Booth, Charles Guiteau and Leon Czolgosz played in American history?
They've all assassinated presidents.
They did indeed, yes. Lincoln, Garfield and McKinley. Question or nominate?
Geoffrey, please.
Geoffrey, on Monday the 9th of March, Commonwealth Day, a baton relay set off from the forecourt of Buckingham Palace. Which Far East Commonwealth capital city was its destination?
Singapore.
Kuala Lumpur. Amy again, please.
Brian, please.
Brian, food and drink. The success of which dessert is based on the principle that beaten egg whites are a poor conductor of heat?
Baked Alaska.
That's it, indeed. Question or nominate?
Geoffrey.
Geoffrey, the words of which hymn associated with community singing at an annual sports event were written by the Scottish hymn writer Henry Francis Light?
Abide with me.
Question or nominate?
Nominate Brian.
Brian, mathematics. What name is given to any four-sided plane figure in which the opposite sides are equal in length?
A parallelogram.
Yes. Question or nominate?
Amy.
Botany, Amy. What adjective describes trees that are cone-bearing?
Coniferous.
Question or nominate?
Brian, please.
Brian, please look at that and tell me. This lady is a famous name in racing. What's her name?
Jenny Pittman.
Question or nominate?
Geoffrey.
Astronomy. Which planet in the solar system is referred to by the adjective Jovian?
Jupiter.
Question or nominate?
Nominate Amy.
Amy, the royal family. What relation to the present Queen was the man on the throne when she was born in 1926?
Grandfather.
Yes, George V. Question or nominate?
Question.
European monarchy. The last king of Greece now lives in exile in England. What's his name?
Constantine.
Question or nominate?
Question.
A standard piece of laboratory equipment. What's the name of the small graduated glass tube used for delivering accurate quantities of liquid?
Pipette.
Question or nominate?
Question.
Classic television. The name, please, of Blackadder's servant who always had a cunning plan.
Baldric.
Question or nominate?
Question.
Quotations. Which American film actress and singer said, I was born at the age of 12 on a Metro-Goldwyn-Mayer lot?
Judy Garland.
Question or nominate?
Question.
The building of the shrine of the Virgin Mary at Lourdes was inspired by the visions of which saint?
Bernadette.
Question or nominate?
Question.
BBC Radio. In which programme on Radio 4 are famous people subjected to personal questions from Dr. Anthony Clare?
In the psychiatrist's chair.
Question or nominate?
Question.
Philosophy. What term is used to describe someone who denies the existence of a god?
Atheist.
Question or nominate?
Question.
Children's literature. The creation of a famous children's author. How are Julian Anne, George Dick and Timmy the dog collectively known?
The famous five.
Question or nominate?
Question.
Astronomy again. Which planet is named after the Roman god of war?
Mars.
Question or nominate?
Question.
With the whole world watching, he made history at 02:56 GMT on the 21st of July 1969. His name, please?
Neil Armstrong.
Question or nominate?
Question.
Medicine. Hyperglycemia is an excess of what in the blood?
Glucose, sugar.
Or sugar, yes, sugar or glucose. Question or nominate?
Question.
Sidmouth, Budley, Salterton and Dawlish are on the coast of which county?
Devon.
I think Brian and Geoffrey, you, we should come on a different day, don't you? Amy, what can I say? 263, 20 for those two, 283, position number one on the finals board, and certainly setting the running, if nothing else, for our top of the finals board trophy. My goodness, what a score so early in the series. Well done, Geoffrey.
Thank you.
And well done, Brian. And well done, Kim. And we'll be back tomorrow, same time, same place. See you then.
comedy times two in just over an hour when Four's showing a double edition of Friends starting at 5:30. And on Four Next, the Stipe takes on the unbeaten woman in the first semi-final of Countdown's Champion of Champions.